Hello, fellow human! Welcome back to another Dank Doggo r/ Choosing Baggers! So our story for today is from u/ Funzy Bob, with the title of Begs for a lift to the airport, demand it's done on their terms, I legally risking my driver's license, that's not going to happen. A while back, this one. Some background though, I'd once driven a friend who didn't wear their seatbelt and coped a $300 fine for it. To this story, a family's friend's sons needed lift to the airport early one morning for a long planned trip. I lived about 10 miles from their place, and the 30-mile trip I was taking to work the opposite direction took me right past the airport, so it was a bit extra time out of the morning. 15 miles to the west to pick up their sons, then 45 miles to the east instead of 30s, but they begged. And both phoned me, and I said I was good to give them a lift. I turned up in the morning, loaded up their gear, the sons both in the car, and said goodbye to their parents, and we took off. Drove a few miles up the freeway, and my seatbelt alert starts pinging. Son number one, in the front seat, had taken off his belt. I asked him to put on, and he goes, "Nah, I don't do seatbelts." So I pull over. Look back at the other son in the back seat, which didn't have the alarms, and sure enough, he'd taken his belt off too. Then the arguing started. I was blunt as I could be that I'm not risking my license and my money so they could get a free lift, and I didn't care one way or another about. Roughly as follow, paraphrase because it was years ago, but they were both in on it. Me, I'm not moving the car unless the belts are on. I've been fined once before, not doing it again. Son 1. I told you, I don't do seatbelts, that is okay with it. Me, I'm not. And you, son 2, yours on too. Not moving until they are on. Son number 1. Do you have any idea how dangerous they are in an accident? Me, blink. Son 1 then puts his behind him and clicks in. Me, no, belt goes around you, doesn't count. Son 1, it'll turn off the alarm. Go, you'll see, we need to get going. Me, we can when you put the belt on. I don't give a crap about the alarm. I care it's $600 fine if you two don't have belts on. Son 2, come on, we'll be late. Me, your flight is not for another hour and a half, belts on. Son number 1 then calls his dad, complains we have stopped, dad asks why, son 1 explains, then his dad tells him to just put the belt on. Son 1 says okay, but didn't notice, I heard his dad sighs too, and said his dad says I need to get a move on. Me, not until belts are on. This go back and forth to the point that I'll be late for work if I didn't get going. Son 1 is all, fine then, turn around, I'll get dad to drive. Me, belts on then. Son 1, no, I told you already. Me, then we're not moving. I get out my phone and browse idly, showing I'm not moving until their seatbelts go on. Son 1 phones his dad again, his dad sounds pissed, but agrees to pick them up. Both sons get out, take their bags, one slams the door, and Booth and I drive off, choosy baggers left behind. I get to work, then get a phone call that son 2 left his main luggage in my car and they want it drop off at the airport urgently. They're flying out soon and they need it now. I tell them to get a taxi, I will meet them out back of my work. They decide to argue it's my responsibility to get them luggage and again argue the point. Half an hour later, one turns up in a taxi to get the other's luggage. I should note here, I really don't know these guys well at all. I know one's name for sure, and I think I know the other, but I might have mixed them up with a cousin from the same suburb. Later that afternoon, I get a phone call from their dad that I've wasted his son's tickets that they weren't able to fly out, couldn't rebook quickly, and they miss half of their vacation time now, and it was all my fault for stopping for so long. I tried to explain as clearly as possible that I wasn't going to risk another huge fine and piss off my employer just for the inconvenience of a couple of ungrateful idiots, but ended up just hanging up on him. I'm still friends with their mother, who was the original friend of the family, but things are a bit strained between me and her husbands and sons. For what it's worth, sons were about 21 years old and 24 at the time it happened. Wow, I genuinely thought the two sons were freaking toddlers, like around 6 years old or whatever. I don't do seatbelts. Things were like, what, a middle school trend? They were clearly not in their teens anymore, and probably attending college at that point, yet still behaving like apes. Do they even got brains? Like, holy crap. I mean, doing a favor or not, 21 to 24 years old is old enough that you can just say, get the duck out of my car and deal with your own crap, while you can just drive off. My car, my rules, end of discussion. Like, nobody can even show the slightest sympathy toward them. The mean person said I had to wear a seatbelt. Yeah, right. Also, correct me if I'm wrong, but in some country like Denmark, Canada, and some state in the US, I believe that as long as you're an adult and not mentally challenged, the person not wearing the seatbelt gets the fine, not the driver. And talk about the maturity level, man. What kind of two fully grown-ups call their dad multiple times about literally everything, asking permission to what? Not to wear seatbelts? Really? And what, dad is okay with it? Like, wow. And the saddest part is that their parent actually put up with such behavior. What a moron. He really got some serious parenting issue. What's even wrong with them in believing seatbelts are dangerous in accidents? It was destined to save people. Not to mention people that don't wear seatbelts become deadly projectiles that can kill innocent people that are wearing their seatbelts. Like, I'm super curious, how will they behave on a plane? The flight attendant will be like, please, fasten your seatbelts, we are ready to take off. And the bagger will be like, I don't do seatbelts. Oh, and by the way, remember that they begged OP to get them a free lift, so shameless of them and ungrateful. I'm glad that OP stick to his guns and they wasted their plane tickets as a lesson. That's it for today, fellow humans. Thanks for watching. Dank Doggo appreciates your time. If you enjoy our content and want to see more of us, stay tuned and subscribe. Don't forget to smash that like button or Doggo will cry. Also, you can always tell us your Doggo comrades, your experiences in the comment section. I'll catch up with you guys later in the next video.